Hi, I'm Arnaud. I joined the Vite team at the end of last year, and I've since maintained the React plugins, with a focus on improving hot module replacement, or HMR for short. The goal of HMR is to be able to update the page with a new version of the UI code without losing the current state. In this no framework folder, I've set up a small example to showcase Vite HMR. There are three pieces. First, a global state that will be persisted through updates. The module also contains some utils to create and render DOM nodes. Then the UI code, in a module that doesn't contain any side effect, so it's safe to rerun it. Finally, an entry point that will mount the counter into the DOM. Currently, there is no HMR code, so any edit to the code will trigger a full page load. Vite HMR API is available through import.meta.hot. It's only available in development, so we need to use an optional chaining for that. The accept method is the base functionality of the API. It will mark the module as being able to handle update of itself. It accepts an optional callback that will be called during updates. The new module is passed as an argument. It can be undefined if the update fails due to a syntax error, for example. If the update succeeds, I can render the new version of the counter. Here I have a syntax error, a TypeScript error, because this no property access from index signature flag is enabled. To remove the TypeScript error, I need to use the index syntax to show that the module is not strongly typed. Now, when I edit the UI code, Vite will trigger an HMR update and call this method, the Vite client will call this method, that will render the new version of our counter while preserving the state. This example is a bit clunky because this render method restarts from scratch every time, but it helps to get the overall idea of how HMR works. Let's see how HMR works for React. To be able to auto-update components, the React team developed Fast Refresh. It's constituted of two parts, a client that needs to be loaded first, and a Babel plugin that will update the source code to register React component for Fast Refresh. To visualize the code transformation done by plugins, I'm using the awesome Vite plugin spec from Anthony. I have the UI open here. Let's look at the transformation for the app.tsx. The React plugin runs first. This change here is done by the Babel plugin. It will register React component for fast refresh using a global variable that is injected, that is available via the React refresh client. This code transformation is also available in SWC. And this is why you have two options when creating a new Vite project and choosing React. The default one based on Babel, or the SWC plugin that will use the SWC. My advice is to use the SWC for big projects that don't require any specific Babel plugin. It will lead to faster starts in development. The React plugin also injects this code at the bottom of the file to integrate Fast Refresh with Vite HMR API. So we will come back to it. Then exbuild is used to transform JSX and remove types. Finally, Vite looks at the output. It does two things. It writes imports to be valid ESM imports and looks for usages of the HMR API. If the module is using the .accept callback, it will be marked as being able to self-update. This information is saved in a module graph that looks like this. In green are file modules that can self-update. When editing this kind of module, like the local counter component, Vite will send an event via WebSocket connection to all connected browsers so that they can request the new version of the module. The new module will then be passed to this callback and pass to the fast refresh client that will be able to render the new version of the REC, of the REC components. When editing a file that doesn't contain any HMR capabilities, like the display file here, Vite will look at all importers recursively until it finds a list of modules that can accept the update. Here, it will be these two counter components. In that case, HMR is performed on these two components that will then request the new version of the module via ESM import. We can see it in the logs here. When the propagation reaches the root, like when updating this init monitoring file, for example, Vite will fall back to a full page reload. A full page reload will also happen when the propagation detects a cycle, so it's better to avoid circular imports. This way of doing HMR has a downside. It doesn't work well with barrel export, like this index file re-exporting all the other utils files. Currently, when I update the mass file, both components are updated. But in reality, only the global counter is importing a mass function. So I can update the import here and remove the re-export here. Now, when I edit the mass file, only the global counter is HMR. In a big project, this can lead to a big difference in terms of HMR performances. Let's go back to the accept callback. Here, the REC plugin will verify that conditions for fast refresh are met. A limitation of fast refresh is that the module needs to only export React component. This can be a bit problematic when you want to export a function that was before local to your component. In that case, to ensure good HMR, it's better to move the function to another file. In the future, I may find a solution for special cases like React router or loader function that benefit a lot from collocation. There is one exception that I've added to the Vite integration. When exporting a primitive value, like a string or a number, the plugin will verify that the value hasn't changed and that it's safe to do the update. If the value changes, or if the file is exporting something else than a REC component, the module will invalidate itself by using the invalidate function from Vite HMR API. It will send a message via the WebSocket to the dev server to tell the dev server to restart the search for boundaries from there. Here, it will be directly found on the app.tsx file. This will allow to preserve state, which is nice. In similar cases, Next.js currently falls back to a full page reload. A case where it's common to not respect the fast refresh limitation is when using the context API, either by exporting the context object or a custom hook that wraps the use context one. I've personally taken the habit to split my context into two files. The context in one file, that can be a TS file, and the provider, that can become safely HMR. To help catch these kind of issues, I've created an ESLint plugin that is included in the React Starter template since Vite 4.3. Finally, let's look at another part of the HMR API that you can use to enhance HMR in your Vite project. Here, I have an example of a dynamic configuration that is shared in the app through a Sushtan store. The initial config is written in JSON. Currently, when I update the config, the HMR propagates to two components. This is fine in this demo, but can lead to a slower HMR if a lot of components are using this hook. To change that, I can use the HMR API and use another signature of the accept callback that takes two arguments. In the first argument is the list of dependencies that the module can handle update of. And the callback will be called on update. The update can also fail, so we need to wait for that. And here, if the HMR succeed, I can update the source transistor with the new value of the configuration, which is the default export. Now, if I update the initial config, it will propagate to the use config file and be accepted as a dependencies, and this file will be HMR. Then the Sushtan will be able to update right component to keep the UI up to date. That's it for me.